Yo, what is up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I am choosing my Madden 18 franchise. Thank you guys for commenting in the last episode I had for the Madden 18, telling you guys to help me choose. It wasn't an episode, I guess, a video. Having you guys choose who you wanted me to be. It went a long way in making my decision. But like I said, you guys can comment, but ultimately I'll make the final decision because it's going to be a team that I will be wanting to play with, a team that I'll be wanting to rebuild, and ultimately hopefully go multiple seasons deep in this franchise. So we go through the teams. My favorite team, the Minnesota Vikings. Didn't really want to choose them. They're a pretty good team. There's the Cleveland Browns, a big rebuild process. I kind of thought about the Cardinals. A lot of veterans, it'd be a big roster rebuild after 1 year. Maybe compete the first year, but then move on from there. Then there's the 49ers. That's a complete rebuild. The Jaguars are very interesting to me. I really like the roster they have there. You see me stop on there just a little bit. There's the Jets, who are a huge rebuild, maybe one of the biggest, tied with the 49ers. And then there was the Los Angeles Rams, but I feel like they just have really something going for them there. So my decision came down to a few teams: 49ers, Jets, or the Cardinals. And I went to the San Francisco 49ers, probably the biggest rebuild, tied with the Jets for the biggest rebuild, one of the worst rosters in the NFL. Nothing even remotely close to a future at quarterback. Have a good running back in Carlos Hyde. Have a decent defensive line. But other than that, they are very lackluster. We're going to continue here with Kyle Shanahan as a head coach. I wasn't quite sure if I want to be an owner or a head coach. Decided to go with head coach Kyle Shanahan. And I really like him as a young coach that we have. We'll go pre-existing injuries on. Quarter length 12 minutes. Minimum play clock time 18. And then I'll do everything manually myself. And I'm really looking forward to starting this franchise with the San Francisco 49ers. It's going to be a big rebuild, but I'm hoping after a couple seasons of drafting and free agency that we can get back into the playoffs with the San Francisco 49ers. You know, they had that huge controversy with Colin Kaepernick last year. Couldn't really quite get out of the news with Colin Kaepernick kneeling during the national anthem, which has caused great concern, but no one really realized how bad of a team this is until you look at their roster and their best. I mean, they have one really good position, and that's fullback. They have the best fullback in the game, and that is their highest rated guy, and that is really the only 90 overall that they have on the team. They have some decent pieces in Solomon Thomas, DeForest Buckner, Carlos Hyde, Pierre Garçon's a good receiver, George Kittle, a rookie tight end out of Iowa, but their QBs are Brian Hoyer and C.J. Beathard. Brian Hoyer is not going to be here to stay, I can tell you that right now, and I'm not quite sure C.J. Beathard is going to develop into a very decent quarterback either. He might be a decent backup, but he's definitely not going to be a very good starter for us. So, you definitely know that quarterback has to be a position that we evaluate. I'm going to go position by position and tell you who I have and what I think I need from that position and if it needs a change or not. We're going to be starting at quarterback after I show you a couple of top dudes. But here is Brian Hoyer, 31 years old, 76 overall, just not going to cut it. He'll probably be the QB the first year, then hopefully we can get a good QB in the draft or in the offseason free agency. But like I said, he's not going to cut it. And C.J. Beathard, he's probably not going to be a starter. 74 overall, 23 years old. He can do enough. He could be enough as a backup if we need him for an injured starter. But he may get some playing time this year. He may get a few starts in year one. But that just may be because we're going to be tanking. But don't let the NFL know. There's Carlos Hyde, a very good halfback. And he's actually heading into a contract year. But he's got three rookies behind him. So he's going to be carrying most of the workload. And this is a big year for him, heading into the contract year. Right now, I'm not quite sure if I want to hold on to Carlos Hyde or not. He might be asking for a lot of money, and if I can dump him and just start fresh everywhere in here, then I would definitely be down for that. But if he has a good year, I'm gonna have to re-sign him because he's a very good halfback, and I can continue to rebuild around him, and he's 26 years old. And he's gonna be blocked for by our 91 overall fullback. But then you get to wide receiver, and it is bad. You have Pierre Garçon, 31 years old, though, but he's 87 overall. He'll be very decent. But then you have Marquise Goodwin, Robinson, Taylor, Burbridge, and Smelter. It is not very good at wide receiver. It's going to be a long year for the quarterback, whether it's Brian Hoyer or C.J. Beathard, and they're going to be looking for Pierre Garçon 90% of the time. Then there's our tight end, George Kittle. He is very good in the preseason. In real life, I hope that can reflect in the franchise mode because he is a very good tight end and hopefully can do a lot for us. We do have a very good left tackle in Joe Staley, and he's 33 years old, so I'm hoping I can get a few years out of him. But he is very good, and he's going to be solid for us at left tackle for the first couple of years. But then the rest of the offensive line is not so good. Brandon Fresco there, you see, 73 overall. A lot of just upper 20s, high 20s, but they're mid-70s overall. So the offensive line is definitely going to need some rebuilding. But then we get to the strength of our team, the defensive line. Elvis Dumervil, 85 overall, but he may be traded at 33 years old, and we have Aaron Lynch and Eric Armstead right behind him. Eric Armstead, 23, Aaron Lynch, 24, and Elvis Dumervil's 33. And I really like the upside of Lynch and Armstead more than I do Dumervil. And then our right end, we have Solomon Thomas. He's a superstar potential or progression, whatever you want to call it. He's 21 years old, 81 overall. He is going to be very good. Then we have DeForest Buckner, an 81 overall defensive tackle at 23 years old. You see the quick development he's got there. He's also going to be very, very good. So the defensive line is very solid, and Elvis Dumervil may be the first guy you see off this team. Then we have Eli Harrell, that left outside linebacker, not so good, and you'll see that is quite the trend for the rest of this defense. Eli Harrell, he's not going to cut a left outside linebacker. He's 73 overall. He can't cover anybody. He may be there to stop the run, but he can't do anything else. But then there's Navarro Bowman, a very, very good player, superstar potential, but he's already 89 overall. He's getting a little bit up there in age, but I believe we do have him for another 6 years. Yeah, 6 years remain on the contract, so he may be with us for a couple of years, or I may just look to get rid of him and have him go chase a ring as he's getting up there in age. We'll have to wait and see what I want to do. He's 29 years old, 6 years contract. He'll be with us till he's 35. But then there's Reuben Foster, a right outside linebacker. I like him a lot, and his backup, Malcolm Smith. We're very good at that side of the linebacker position. But then we're going to get into the secondary. And the secondary, I'll tell you right now, is not the strongest whatsoever. Rashad Robinson can become a very good corner. Hopefully not a number one corner for this team. Hopefully we'll find someone else. And then you get to Kawan Williams. He's 74 overall. He's our second corner. That's going to be tough. Then we get to Dante Johnson, then Witherspoon, then Reaser, then Jackson. It just really falls off after Rashad Robinson. Then we go to free safety. Jimmy Ward's decent. He's got 2 years left on his contract. Don't know if I want to trade him or if I want to hold on to him for two more years while we're rebuilding. It doesn't make a lot of sense to have a really good safety, but he's only going to be here for the rebuild, and then after 2 years, he's gone. So I'm not quite sure what I'll do about that. Maybe I could re-sign him after 2 years. He's still pretty young. We'll have to wait and see. Then we go to strong safety, and it's Eric Reed, 77 overall, 25 years old. Hopefully he can progress very decently. But then we get to our special teams, and it's Robbie Gould. He is getting up there in age, 35 years old, 74 overall. And then punter is Bradley Pinion. He's 23 years old, 70 overall. But here is the most intriguing part, the draft picks. We have a first rounder, 2 seconds and 2/3. That is very solid. 5 draft picks in the first 3 rounds and the first 70 picks as of right now, obviously, before the year ends. And 2 7s, but that doesn't mean as much to me as the 2 seconds and the 2/3. So this roster is bad. We know that. We know this roster is not very good. But if the team can really put together just some decent outings here in the first season, in year one, I'll be happy with that, getting just a few wins out of this team, get them some momentum sort of going into year two, but not being any good, because this is not a playoff team unless I just play absolutely fantastic, turnover free, big play after big play. Then we would have a chance to make the playoffs, but I can tell you right now, that's probably not going to happen. So I want to win a few games, but I don't want to be good enough where I get like the, you know, the 13th, 14th pick in the draft, didn't make the playoffs, but I'm not a top 10 pick. I would love to just either win 4 or 5 games and get a top 5 pick, or I make the playoffs. So we'll have to see how year one goes. I think it's going to be more of the top 5 pick than anything else, but we'll have to wait and see how that turns out. This is going to be quite the rebuild with Brian Hoyer at quarterback. CJ Beathard might get some starts. That's actually a question for you guys right away. Would you rather see Brian Hoyer week one starter, or would you rather see CJ Beathard? You'll see me put CJ Beathard in here in just a minute. I do a couple of reps in practice here with Brian Hoyer. He's pretty decent. I'm Brian CJ Beathard. He does not have a deep ball. CJ Beathard doesn't. But then again, with this offensive line, how often am I going to be able to throw the deep ball? I'm not really sure. The defense, on the other hand, I think they could be pretty good for us, especially the defensive line could get some good pressure on the quarterback. We have a lot of depth, and even if I traded Elvis Dumervil, we still have depth in Aaron Lynch and Eric Armstead at one side. So I don't think we're going to be lacking much depth there this year, but I do think with the defense, with this kind of offense, the defense might be on the field a little bit more than they would like, and obviously that's going to wear on a defense, and they're going to get up more points than you would expect a good defense to give up. So we'll have to wait and see. The secondary is very bad, though, so that's where I see a lot of points coming up, a lot of just broken down in coverage, whether it's our cornerbacks or whether it's the free safeties, because Eric Reed's a very good strong safety, but he's not a coverage strong safety. He is definitely a hard-hitting strong safety. But that being said, Jimmy Ward is very decent as well, so he could make some plays for us. I just don't know if the corners are going to be able to match up against some other people that we will face. I don't know if any of the cornerbacks can cover someone like Julio Jones in the NFC, or even like Stephon Diggs, Adam Thielen, or they can guard Mike Evans, or anybody like that. I'm not quite sure that can happen. And then our linebacker position, I really do like Reuben Foster and Malcolm Smith, and then I also have Ray Armstrong, so I really like the right outside linebacker position. I feel like I got a lot of depth, and maybe, just maybe, I will put Malcolm Smith at left outside linebacker, because Eli Harold is not very good, and I'm not quite sure. He's definitely not going to be sticking around, but he's just a filler right now, but maybe Malcolm Smith can go there, and we will actually end up having a decent linebacking core there, led by Navarro Bowman, that middle linebacker. He hopefully can be everywhere on the field and make a lot of tackles. That would go a long way for this defense, and we would definitely need it. But that is the strengths and weaknesses for this team. They're not going to be very good, but maybe that's a good thing. To have fewer expectations, you can really go out and just play freely and play loose, and we'll have to see how well it comes together in week one against the Carolina Panthers at home. Looking to get a big victory it is, but you guys let me know who you want to see week one starter, and if you're excited for this franchise. I'm ready to get back in the Madden franchise. Been a while since I've posted on the channel, but I hope you guys did enjoy today's episode. If you did, make sure you hit the like button, and as always, I'm out. Peace.